So after talking about the theory of advanced workflow concept, I would like to show you something in a real orchestrator environment and give you a couple of demos about those concepts. So this is actually the runbook designer, so the tool where you're going to create and edit your runbooks within your orchestrator environment. And on the left, you will see all your runbooks, and you're able to organize them using folders. So I'm going ahead and create a folder called Microsoft Virtual Academy, and there I'm going to create one runbook. So I click on New Runbook. And the first thing you're going to see is that this is called New Runbook, and I'd like to give that a better name than this one. And I'm right-click on that and say Rename and call. And yes, the first thing that I'm going to be asked is if I would like to check out this runbook. There's some idea of checking in, checking out runbooks. So as soon as you want to edit a runbook, you have to check out this runbook. And I say yes here. And then I'm able to give it a different name, and I would like to check for some Windows service and the status for that. And then I'm able to create my runbook and my workflow here. So the first thing that I have to add is a starting point. And I've mentioned that you have to have some sort of starting point and a single starting point for every runbook. And with that, I'm going to use the monitor date time activity out of the scheduling part of the foundation objects. And the first thing I do is I double click on that, and I say, well, let run that runbook every 20 seconds. Click on Finish, and then I would like to go and check for a specific service on a server, and I'm going to the Monitoring tab here, and I go to the right and use the Get Service Status, and I add that to the design pane, and I'm go and link the Monitor Date Time to the Get Service Status activity. I will also give that a nice name called Get, and we are going to check for the DHCP client status. Okay, then we double click on that activity, and we define on which server it should check for that service, and I'm going to use the orchestrator machine in my case. And then which service I would like to check. And if you click on that button here to the right, you get all the services on that specified machine. And I'm going to use the DHCP client service for that. And then I'm done. So as soon as I would check in now and run that runbook, it will run every 20 seconds and check for the status of that DHCP client service. Let me see. What's the status here? So it's started, so it's running, but we haven't defined any activity after that. So it will check for the status, but it won't do anything after that. So, and therefore would like to add some notification, and I would like to add something to the event log of that machine. So I'm going ahead and grab the send event log message. I will link the Get DHCP client status activity to that event log message. I will also give that activity a better name. So I will call it success event log. And what we've discussed in the slides was also the idea and the concept of link logic. So the status might be running or it might be stopped, and depending on the status, I would like to do a different event log information to the server. So I'm adding another send event log message, and I'm using another link from the very same activity here to that send event log message, and I will say, well, if there is, just want to rename that, if there is an error or it's not running, then it will do something differently. So how will Orchestrator knows what to do with those different links? Right now, it if I would run this runbook, it will use both event log activities because I haven't defined anything on the links itself. So if I double click on the first link, you will see it will check for the GET DHCP client status if that returns a success. So in case it's not failing for whatever reason, maybe connectivity issues or something like that, you're able to go forward with that flow. But we would like to look for the service status of that activity. So up here you have the activity, that's the DHCP client status activity, and we're going to use that service status data. That's one of the variables that got published from the activity. So we click on OK here. And then we also able to define our conditions. This time we are fine with the equals, and then we go ahead and say if the service is running. And then I also have the option to change the colors. So in this case, I would like to use a green color to say and to make it visible that everything is fine. I can define the width here, and I also able to create a name for the link. So this is service is running, and as soon as you have defined that, so I would like to put it a little bit away so that it's readable. And as soon as you have defined that in the options, you there is an option saying show link labels. If that's checked, then you will see that those link labels here in the design surface. So, and in the error event, we define the same here for the service status of that activity equals service stopped. Okay, and we define a different color here. In this case, as it stopped, it's an error for us. So, and we say the name is service is stopped. And then the only thing we have to do is add some text to the event log. So which is the server we are want to add that event information. So we are going to use the same for demo reason. We use the same machine, and we would like to add some text here. And this is the success event log. So we define the severity to information and say service, and then we would like to tell or give the message, or we'll add some information about the service itself. So in this case, we want to use publish variables from the data bus. So we're going to right click, click on subscribe, publish data. And there I can grab from the client status, I can grab the display name, the service display name. So it will add the display name of whatever is defined there and add that to the message that will be posted to the event log, and we just say that's that service is running. Finished. And in the error event log, same machine. Service, and we are going to use the same published data here, and the service display name is not running, and this time we want to mark that as an error. So with that, we are done with the editing of that runbook. We're able to check in that runbook, and as soon as I've checked in the runbook, I'm able to run it. So I click that button up here, and you will see that immediately that check service tab here changed its icon to run. In the log down here, that has all the real-time information on running and currently running runbooks. And you will, if you open that up, you'll see the activities that are part of the current runbook. And if we go to the log history, you see immediately that this runbook was run already one time. And if we double click on that, you see all the information of the activities that are available. And if we now go to the event log, press F5, you'll see we have already three different items here. We double click and say, you'll see the text that we've edited. So service and the DHCP client is the published data that we've used, is not running here. And if we go back to the service itself and go ahead and start that service, it will take a couple of seconds that we will see the result here in the event log as well. The runbook is still running because it runs every 20 seconds. So let's wait a couple of seconds and then we will see another entry here in the log history. That's done. And then if we go to the log and press F5, you see that change from error to information saying service DHCP client is running. So we're done with the first runbook, and we've covered a couple of the topics from the slides, starting points, link logic, and now I would like to stop that here and add another concept. So we are going to check out the runbook again. And now I would like not to only check the status of a specific service once, but I want to do it for example, three times in a row, and then after that I would like to say if it's running or not. So if we double click on that activity, we have that option here called looping. So if I click on looping, the first thing I have to do is to enable that looping. Then I have to define the seconds of delay between the different attempts. So I'm saying every 3 seconds go ahead and run that specific activity, and then we have to define the exit status for that. So if the status of that service, so we're going to use again a published data here, if that status is equals to service running, then we would like to exit immediately, and we add another one saying okay, so we need to add the show common published data, because I don't want to run that forever. We are going to add the loop number of attempts to add that here to the exit statement, and then saying, well, if that's is greater than or equal to, and we say, okay, we want to check that only 3 times, so it will take up to 9 seconds. So if either of those two statements is true, either the service is running or we had checked it already 3 times, then we want to exit that loop. And then we have to click on finish here, and you see the loop link here already. And then we're going ahead, click on check in. And you see in the log history, you see one failed event, because that's was happening because I stopped it, and it was, as it runs all the time, there's the last one that failed, of course. And if you double click here, you'll see that the activity monitor daytime failed in this case. So again, we're clicking on run, and we will see an entry here in the real-time information immediately. Not quite sure about the status of the service itself. I think it is running right now. Yeah. So let's go back. So now I will show you, first I will show you the loop in this time as the service is running, and we defined the exit statement. So as soon as it's running, exit that loop immediately. You will see if we click on the log history, you will see that the get DHCP client status, that's the one that we've defined the loop on, is happening only once, okay, because it's running and the exit statement was true. So if we go ahead and stop that service, go back to the orchestrator designer, there is another guy running already. Let's see what's the output now, because now the exit statement, the first exit statement is not true, the service is not running, and the second one says exit only after the third attempt of that loop. So let's see what the log history says now. Now you see the difference here. You have 3 entries of the get DHCP client status, and that's because it checked for the status 3 times, and then it goes to the error event log. Whereas the one before, it goes to the success event log and it exits the first time of that loop. So that's about looping on an activity level. So with that, we're almost done. A quick summary for that session. We covered concepts like nesting and looping on an object level as well as on a runbook level, and a couple of use cases for each. We discussed the link logic, how to work with smart links, how to do filtering on published data, how to implement decisions within your runbooks, and also how to understand and how to work with variables. And last but not least, we discussed the data manipulation functions, both for strings and numeric values. That's all part of that session. And with that, I would just like to highlight again the different options you will find out in the net to get more information. First of all, go to TechNet Eval Center on TechNetMicrosoft.com/EvalCenter. There are a lot of software and trial versions available at no cost. Then there is TechNetMicrosoft.com Global IT Champs, which gives you technical trainings also at no cost for IT pros. And of course, the Microsoft Virtual Academy that offers also online technical trainings on MicrosoftVirtualAcademy.com. So thanks for joining for this session, and see you soon on the next one around Orchestrator 2012.